Welcome to the commencement exercises for the class of 2023. Please welcome Kayla Walker with the introduction.
Ladies and gentlemen, honored guests, faculty, parents, and most importantly, the graduating class of 2023. On behalf of the Student Council, as Student Council Vice President, it is with immense joy and pride that I stand before you today as we gather to celebrate this astounding achievement. Today, we not only celebrate your academic accomplishments, but we also honor your character, your growth, and your contributions to our school community. You have made lasting memories, formed lifelong friendships, and discovered your passions, talents, and dreams. For some, your involvement in academics, sports, arts, and extracurricular activities, you have enriched our school with your diverse skills and unwavering spirit. You have come a long way since the beginning of your journey 4 long years ago, and you should be proud of yourself. As you embark on the next chapter of your journey, remember that this moment is not just an endpoint. It is a stepping stone towards a future filled with boundless opportunities. Whether you continue your education, pursue a career, or explore the world, let your high school experience be the foundation of your success and a milestone that proves you can achieve greatness. I would like to take a moment to acknowledge the educators who have guided you throughout your high school journey. Let us express our heartfelt gratitude to them for their unwavering commitment and passion. To the parents, guardians, and families, today is a moment of great pride for you as well. You have been a pillar of support, providing love, encouragement, and guidance to these exceptional young individuals. Your belief in their abilities and your sacrifices have pushed them to become the people they are today. Finally, to the graduating class, cherish this day and the memories you have created together. As you move forward, remember the friendships you have made, the lessons you have learned, and the experiences that have shaped you into the person you are today. Today marks the beginning of a new chapter, one filled with endless possibilities and opportunities. As you step out into the world, never forget the strength, resilience, and determination that have brought you to this very moment. Congratulations once again, class of 2023. Thank you all, and let the graduation ceremony begin.
If you would please stand for the presentation of the colors by our junior ROTC under the direction of Brian Carroll, and the singing of the national anthem by Wolfgang, directed by Dean Wolf.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the
I wait till they finish?
Hello, this evening I would like to introduce our School City of Hobart Administration, Superintendent Dr. Peggy Buffington, Director of Early College and Careers, Ms. Brooke Burchek, Director of Early Learning and Education, Mrs. Sarah Gutierrez, Director of Elementary Curriculum and Instruction, Ms. Laurie Anderson, Director of Secondary Curriculum and Instruction, Dr. Tim Krieg, Director of Social Emotional Learning, Mrs. Debbie Mathis, Director of School Counselors, Mrs. Danielle Adams, Director of Student Services, Mr. Matthew Weitzman, Director of Human Resources and Compliance, Mr. Jonathan Mock, Business Manager, Mr. Robert Glover Jr. Our School Board of Trustees, President, Mr. Terry Butler, Vice President, Mrs. Ricky Guthrie, Secretary, Mrs. Sandra Hillen, Member, Mr. Frank Porras, Mrs. Karen Robbins, Mr. Donald Rogers, Mr. Stuart Schultz, student members Jeffrey Howard, Gianna Rodriguez.
And the High School Administration and Guidance, co-principals Ms. Colleen Newell and Craig Osika, our Deans of Students, Ty Arthurholtz, Brandy Krolak, Sean Zolatz, our Athletic Director, Michael Black, our school counselors, Shelby Clendaniel, Victoria Hamilton, Amanda Hensley, Peggy Orchard, Heather, and our mental health counselor, Ms. Heather Gansky, our resource officer, Monty White, and the class officers, President Jasmine Alvarez, Vice President Lily Cavazos, Secretary Jenny Lynn Mullins, Treasurer Olivia Aichner, and I am Kathy Nelson, and this is Carrie Roach. Please welcome the class president, Jasmine Alvarez. You may be seated at this time.
Good evening, everyone who has come to join us at the Brickyard on this beautiful day. I am truly honored to be here standing in front of you all representing the class of 2023 as a senior class president. Our time together has been eventful, from Friday night football to amazing class achievements to alleged fake Instagram accounts and to partying by the media center. I think we made the best of it all. Most of us might agree that these 4 years have been the best and most fun years of our lives. Of course, that's without mentioning the stress over a final or submitting a mass amount of late work right before the quarter ended. This year, and some years prior, I've been able to be surrounded by these wonderful souls. I've had the pleasure of getting to know this class and seeing the different types of personalities we bring upon ourselves. Looking back at it, we walked in here fresh out of middle school with a bad reputation, but today I can proudly say our class no longer fits that description. These past 4 years, we have been able to show our strengths, creativity, determination, and passion. We have shown Hobart High School the true side of us that we never thought we had. We all have slowly become young adults who ended up leading and ruling the school, and now we will lead and rule the world. After today, we will be on our way to go on new adventures. The world is a place with endless possibilities, and we are a class who never listens to what may bring us down or change us. We have always stood strong to fight for ourselves and what we want. I want to thank the staff and administration who have taken their own journeys before us to help lead us into our own. I also want to thank our SROs and the School City of Hobart for protecting us in a place that should be safe for education. With that being said, I want to take a moment for all the kids who won't ever have the opportunity to walk the stage due to acts of gun violence in schools. We are very fortunate to receive our diplomas today, as we have gone to school our whole lives, other than the portion where we were all on our Chromebooks. But when you think about it, we have gone to school all those years to get to where we are right now. We literally waited our whole lives for this. We need to enjoy our lives with the devotion to make change and bring a better world upon us. We all have goals, and I truly believe we all can achieve them. There is nothing too beyond that you cannot do. Whether you want to be a doctor, a lawyer, a musician, a writer, an artist, or an athlete, just know that as the years go by, we will still have that teenager in us, but with a bigger burning fire as we grow, reminding you to never give up. We will always be chasing our new goals for years, but even if we don't get there right away, the journey is always the most beautiful moment in life. I wanted to end with a quote I related to during rough times from Kim Namjoon of BTS. Happiness is not something that you have to achieve. You can still feel happy during the process of achieving something. Thank you.
Please welcome class valedictorian Kenji DeCastro.
About 12 years ago, we began our educational journey back in preschool and kindergarten when we were just small little kids looking to have fun on the playground, not having a care in the world. We then moved on to elementary school where we learned how to read, how to count, and how to do math. In third grade, I still remember us memorizing our multiplication facts so that we could slowly build our multiplication Sunday. And in fifth grade, staring at the night sky every day to track the phases of the moon. And at the end of each year, taking the infamous I-step. After fifth grade, Liberty, Riju, and John Martin classes combined at the middle school to create a whole new experience for all of us. We started to take more difficult classes and had higher expectations. But at the same time, we were able to free swim in the pool every week for PE. We participated in sports, and we baked cakes in facts class. And of course, you can't forget about our class's favorite activity of all, silent lunches. It seemed we had silent lunches just about every week, so I don't know, I guess we were just really into them. Now, even though our class was known to be a bit rowdy, we eventually left that behind us at HMS to then start our journey at Hobart High School. And it was at this point when we started to dial in into who exactly we wanted to be. Whether it be with engineering, business, computer science, art, trades, healthcare, human services, ROTC, or sports, all of us pursued our own pathways to get an idea of what we wanted to do after high school. And in those 4 years of pulling all-nighters to write 10-page essays, failing to understand what the heck was going on in math, or trying to comprehend what our world language teacher was saying, we obviously succeeded given that we're standing here today as proud graduates of Hobart High School. Now, I just recapped our educational story, but what exactly is to come next for us? As we leave the school district and head out into the real world, it could definitely seem scary and daunting. We may, at times, find ourselves lost, not knowing how to move forward from a situation. But if those times ever arise, I wholeheartedly believe that each and every one of us has a strength to overcome. At the end of the day, we are the individuals who ultimately have the power to write our own stories and decide our fate. Because, just as a wise person once told me, the future belongs to those who believe in the beauty of their dreams. Thank you.
Our salutatorian speech, Emily Neuenfeld.
Hello, teachers, staff, guests, and class of 2023. Congratulations on all of your success. We did it. We're graduating. Graduation, by definition, is celebrating the completion of something. In other words, an ending. But today doesn't feel like an ending. Yes, we're leaving high school, but today feels like a beginning. As we receive our diplomas, we are going to walk off of this football field and on to the rest of our lives beyond high school. We have taken many classes during our time here at Hobart High, some easier than others, but if we learned anything during these last several years, we learned of our incredible perseverance and determination. And while we may not be using the second fundamental theorem of calculus in our average life, we have still learned many lessons throughout these last several years. High school has not been without its obstacles and hardships, though. But through our endurance, we have made it onto this football field together this evening. This is an accomplishment that we should all be proud of. But now we must look forward. In the words of Taylor Swift, losing things doesn't just mean losing. A lot of the time, when we lose things, we gain things too. As our time in high school comes to an end, we can take what we learned and use it to make a positive impact. Whether that positive impact is local, national, or global, every single one of us can make a difference. Even if that difference seems small, it can still have a remarkable impact. So, as the moment when we finally get our diploma and start this next chapter of our lives gets closer, I want to go back to what I said at the start of my speech. This is only the beginning. Once again, congratulations, class of 2023.
Now presenting the faculty selected speech, Aiden Howitt.
You got it, Aiden.
Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, and fellow students, thank you all for gathering here today as we bid farewell to another remarkable year. It fills me with great pride to stand before you this evening as we reflect upon the triumphs and challenges we have faced together. As many of you know, I've always believed in the power of unity and indomitable spirit of the American people. Today, we celebrate the culmination of our efforts, the graduating class of 2023. I must say, this is a tremendous class, the best class. Believe me, nobody does it better than you guys. You have shown resilience, determination, and a commitment to excellence that sets you apart. Throughout your journey, you have embraced diversity, cherished freedom, and embodied the values that make this nation truly great. I have witnessed your growth, your academic achievements, and your dedication to making a positive impact in our society. You have truly made everyone around you proud. But let's be honest, it hasn't always been smooth sailing. Life is full of ups and downs, just like a roller coaster. I should know, I've built many great roller coasters. You face unprecedented challenges and emerge stronger than ever. Together, we weathered storms, faced adversity head on, and emerged victorious. Your ability to adapt, innovate, and overcome obstacles is a testament to your character and determination. Remember, when things get tough, never give up. Just keep going and you will come out on top. I want to take a moment to recognize the incredible faculty and staff who have guided you along this remarkable journey. They have provided you with the knowledge, support, and the tools necessary to thrive in an ever-changing world. Let's express our gratitude to these dedicated individuals who have been instrumental in shaping your minds and nurturing your talents. They deserve our utmost appreciation. Today, as you embark on new adventures, whether it be pursuing higher education, entering the workforce, or venturing into uncharted territories, remember that you carry a great responsibility. You are the future leaders, entrepreneurs, and change makers of this great nation. I have no doubt that each and every one of you will leave an indelible mark on the world. You will face challenges, but remember that within every challenge lies an opportunity for greatness. As you move forward, embrace the values that have defined this institution. Cherish the principles of liberty, equality, and justice. Remember to treat others with kindness and respect, regardless of their differences. Always strive for excellence and never settle for mediocrity. Aim high, dream big, and never lose sight of your goals. In closing, let me say this. The world is waiting for you. It's ready to be shaped by your vision, your passion, and your unwavering spirit. Go forth with confidence, courage, and conviction. And always remember the best is yet to come. Thank you and God bless you all.
And now our student board representatives, Jeff Howard and Gianna Rodriguez.
And here you are living, despite it all, said Rupi Kaur, famous poet and artist, one of my all-time favorite poets. Good evening, everyone. My name is Gianna Rodriguez, and some of you know me as Gigi. I had the honor of serving on the school board and had the opportunity to be our voice, along with celebrating lots of accomplishments made throughout this past year. Freshman year, 2019, the year we all thought we were getting that extended spring break, which turned out to be one of the hardest challenges we would ever face. We experienced the effects of COVID while we were in high school. Soon, everyone had downloaded Zoom, and pajama pants had become our daily attire. Now, it wasn't easy, but we were successfully able to pull off virtual and in-person learning, and that is something we should most definitely be proud of. And here we are. Here we are today, lined up for graduation at the Brickyard, despite it all. Hobart High School not only gave us an opportunity to enhance our education and gave us the beginning foundation of our careers, but we were able to make so many connections and memories along the way. To be real, not everyone you've met here is going to stay in your life forever, and hey, that's okay. But there's always a few people that you will keep in your life forever, and I definitely know my people. I invite you all to take a second and realize where we are in this very moment. We are graduating high school. Our dreams are lined up in front of us. The craziest part, you haven't met all of your best friends. You haven't made some of your most fondest memories. You haven't sang some of your most favorite songs. Some of your best days are ahead of you, so this is it, our ending, but also our beginning. I would like to dedicate these last few moments of my speech to my amazing papa, Jaime Devalier. He can't be here today, but I know if he was, he would be front row for this moment. Thank you, Hobart High School, for helping me to develop into the leader and individual I am today. Thank you.
Before I begin, I would like to thank the school board for allowing me and Gianna to serve for the past year and for speaking at our graduation. With that said, to the class of 2023, congratulations, you've made it. 13 years of work put into this moment. Enjoy this moment as you look to the future. And I'm not going to lie to you, I can't see the future. I can't see the present either. With that being said, I would like to simply say congrats. I hope that you all have a great future. I wish you all the best. May God bless you all, and have a good night.
Please welcome School Board President, Mr. Terry Butler.
Class, I have to tell you, I was a little worried following Jeffrey. You have spent your life through tumultuous times. It seems like every time you turn around, there's something new that comes up that puts a roadblock. We need you to be leaders because the times aren't over yet, and we need you to fix it. We also, and I do this every year, we like to celebrate successes and things that people are doing. So anybody that's in the class that's going to go into the armed services, please stand. Please remain standing. Anyone in the audience that has served or will be serving, please stand also. Thank you for your commitment. One more thing for the whole class, because I know you're not here to hear me. Please try to find your family, your support family in the stands, and maybe give them a round of applause for all the work they've done. This is probably one of their favorite days in their life. Thank you, and we'll move on.
With the presentation of the class of 2023, Ms. Colleen Newell and Craig Osika are co-principals.
With the sanction of the State Department of Education of Indiana as an accredited school, the administration and faculty declare that the members of the class of 2023 have met the state and local requirements.
On behalf of the administration and faculty, we wish the class good luck and recommend that they be received with distinction. Congratulations to the class of 2023.
Please welcome our superintendent of schools, Dr. Peggy Buffington.
Good evening. What a perfect night to celebrate Hobart High School's class of 2023. Graduates, as this is your day, I want to thank you for the joy you have brought so many with your spirit of being a true Brickie. We gather here today to honor you. You have been an outstanding class and have provided incredible leadership to the school city of Hobart and beyond. You see, you started out as an experiment. So I need you to stay with me on this one. You were the first full-day kindergarten class at the Early Learning Center. That's right. And you should know we were one of the first school districts to offer full-day kindergarten in the state of Indiana. You were an experiment. We learned a lot from you, including that very first week of school. There were 300 of you. Our first clue that we did not know what we were doing with 300 kindergartners happened in the lunchroom. We learned that you really couldn't do anything by yourself. So here's some examples. When asked your name to ring your lunch in the cafe system, you would simply give your first name. Joshua, what is your last name? He would just simply say, Joshua. Joshua, do you know what your last name is? I told you, Joshua. Okay, Joshua. Joshua, it is. The menu on the first day of lunch, and to this day, I will never forget it, along with your principal, Mrs. Gutierrez. We were having French toast sticks and hash browns with a half-cut peach. You could not open the syrup, you could not open the ketchup or the milk containers, and you were trying to eat the entire half peach without taking a bite. You were dipping French toast into ketchup, hash browns into syrup. You all needed to go outside and we had to hose you off. It was a sticky disaster. There simply were not enough adults to go around that day. At the end of the day, we truly thought we had made it. We had bus numbers all around the gym, bus 23, bus 12, bus 14. You did not know numbers. It took us almost an hour to get you on buses to go home. As we were saying, see you tomorrow, some of you were not so sure about this thing called kindergarten. Neither were we. The teachers wondered why they were kindergarten teachers at that point. And my secretary said to me, you look whooped. I was. The next day, your principal and I were ready for you. We put your lunch numbers on rubber bracelets so that we could get you through the lunch line faster. But you see, you're a friendly group of students. So friendly, you decided to trade your bracelets at recess with your new friends. And despite, we just said, we'll have a new plan tomorrow. You were resilient despite our attempt to do full day kindergarten. Guess what? By the end of the second week of school, you could get in the right line for the bus. By March of that year, you were writing sentences in a paragraph. We had not failed you. We were so excited to watch you learn and grow. Despite a pandemic in high school, you never failed, just like in kindergarten. I see such parallels from those first days. We now see you as the students who run an Instagram account reviewing our lunch program. As students who use computer science and coding to answer questions and score answers in Canvas. The makers and innovators seeking patents for an invention. And the experts in technology piloting artificial intelligence, AI, for the one and only Sal Khan. And yet, there is so much more to this class. At this time, I'd like to share more exciting accomplishments by inviting our Director of School Counseling, Mrs. Danielle Adams, and our Director of Early College and Careers, Ms. Burchek, to recognize the college and career credentials that the class of 2023 has earned.
Good evening. The graduating class of 2023 has 284 graduating seniors. We would like to recognize their accomplishments in college and careers. We have 205 seniors who have participated in career and technical education and completed a CTE concentrator by taking 4 to 6 credits at either the Porter County Career Center or at Hobart High School. There are a total of 245 graduates receiving early college credits. Of those 245 seniors, 163 have earned 15 or more college credits while in high school. This school year alone, the class of 2023 and its cohorts have earned 9,113 college credits with a total savings of $1,462,824.15. Students who earned early college credit or completed a CTE concentrator are wearing a gold stole tonight. At this time, please stand if you are wearing a gold stole and be recognized.
We have students completing the Indiana College Corps, which is a 30-credit sequence that will transfer to public universities in Indiana as 1 year of college. This year, we have 29 students completing this credential. At this time, if you are wearing a white hood, please stand and be recognized as completing the Indiana College Corps. We also have 49 seniors who are earning their associate degree this school year, which means they will leave Hobart High School with both a high school diploma and a 2-year college degree. At this time, if you are wearing a gold hood, please stand and be recognized as completing an associate's degree. Students earning the Indiana College Corps or an associate degree will be recognized when their name is called to receive their diploma. You will hear their name followed by the credential they have earned. Congratulations, class of 2023, on your accomplishments.
Class of 2023, you have accomplished so much. We couldn't be prouder of you. Could I have the audience please applaud for this amazing class? It is truly evident, graduates, that after this evening, we will be honored to call you distinguished alumni of Hobart High School. On this wonderful occasion, as it's been said today, it is important to acknowledge the educators, parents, and family members who have helped you arrive at this point in your lives. This stadium is filled with lots of proud people celebrating you tonight. Graduates, please turn, thank your teachers, parents, and family members with a big round of applause. In your years of school, we have all learned in a monumental way that change is automatic. Change happens whether we like it or not. Change demands adjustments and growth. Growth requires planning, strategies, and focused effort. Growth has to be intentional by every individual. And you have heard us say, be excellent on purpose. As Bricky leaders, you have delivered. Graduates, continue to grow by investing in yourself. As John Maxwell eloquently said, growth is the only guarantee that tomorrow is going to be better. You now have the reins. Lead us into the best future yet. Bricky up. Keep growing by investing in yourself. As you transition into this new journey of life, see your life as a mission to impact as many lives as positively as you can. The difference you make tomorrow begins with the decisions you make today. May your good example of character, work, and relationships influence many lives with an impact that's far-reaching and long-lasting. That oh-so-famous Bricky saying, all my life I want to be a Bricky. Work, work, work. It's so true. It takes hard work to get ahead. Nothing is out of your reach if you work at it. Along the way, be grateful for all of the blessings of life. Do something every day to show compassion and generosity to others. Love sacrificially, and I guarantee it will be returned. On this new road that you pursue, do not forget that this is your home, and we will always be here for you. You are a Bricky. Once a Bricky, always a Bricky. And now, on behalf of the state of Indiana, the Board of School Trustees, our administrative faculty, your teachers from pre-K, kindergarten through 12th grade, the support staff, and the entire community of the School City of Hobart, who have dedicated themselves to your education, I, as superintendent of schools, proudly accept and confirm you, class of 2023. Congratulations.
Before we start with the presentation of diplomas, we are going to ask that you please stay in your seats and don't rush down to the bottom. We want to make sure that everybody can see their graduate walk across the stage. We also ask that you refrain from excessive cheering and yelling and all of that so that we can allow each name to be heard. At the end of each row, we can then hear. Okay. At the end of each row, we will then applaud. Please welcome our school board representatives and our deans, Mr. Arthur Holtz, Ms. Krolak, and Sean Zolatz for the presentation of the diplomas.
First row, please rise and approach the stage.
Olivia L. Eichner, Associate of Science in Liberal Arts, summa cum laude.
Kyle J. Allen, Associate of General Studies, cum laude.
Jasmine Y. Alvarez, Associate of General Studies.
Jason Ryan Anderson.
Julian Arroyo.
Julia R. Ayers.
Caitlin R. Allmiller.
Madeline F. Baltrushaitis, Indiana College Corps, summa cum laude.
Danielle H. Babcock.
Gavin L. Bartolini.
Noah R. Bailey, Associate of General Studies.
Brooklyn M. Bennett.
Aaliyah Rose Bauer.
Benjamin A. Biancolana.
Michaela Janae Berry.
John C. Bizzoni.
Matthew E. Bissick, Associate of General Studies, magna cum laude.
Haley Diane Blood, Indiana College Corps.
Devin W. Bissett. Yeah.
Zacharias Brown.
David G. Brasher Harding.
Allison P. Burns.
Toby Brasher Harding.
Samantha N. Kane.
Vanessa W. Caballo.
Angel Nashe Marie Castellanos.
Aiden Camp.
Second row, please rise and approach the stage.
Eduardo A. Cavazos.
Lillian R. Cavazos, Associate of Science and Liberal Arts, summa cum laude.
Ariana Alexis Siros.
Colton Charo, Indiana College Corps.
Daniel Jacob Chavez.
Mia Charo, Associate of General Studies.
Elena V. Chavez, Associate of General Studies, magna cum laude.
Nevaeh Lanice Chavez.
Chloe B. Chonkoff.
Andrew J. Clemens.
Eliani Blessing Cortez.
Alyssa K. Cotto.
Riley A. Cotton, Associate of General Studies, cum laude.
Brock E. Cobol.
Cameron J. Crane, Indiana College Corps.
Christian Anthony Cruz.
Jacob DeBroa. Yeah.
Kenji A. DeCastro, Associate of Science and Liberal Arts, summa cum laude.
Mariah Alize De Jesus.
Luciano I. Del Toro.
Madison Elizabeth Dombrowski, Associates of Science and Liberal Arts, cum laude.
Abigail Marie Doctor.
Lee Dotson.
Asia J. Donald.
Jacob D. Duggins.
Isabel Dozier.
Riley E. Elkins, Indiana College Corps, summa cum laude.
G. Dwayne Dway. Third row, please rise and approach the stage.
Aaron V. Fabian.
Jonathan A. Espinoza.
Ian E. Ferba, Associate of General Studies.
Austin J. Farr.
Taylor K. Fiddler.
Kyle D. Federick.
Owen Finch.
Alicia M. Figueroa.
Melissa Flores.
Juliet Flores Garcia, Associate of General Studies.
Frederick P. Galindo.
Carrie B. Fortenberry.
Jacob Valentino Galvin.
Louis Michael Gallegos, Associate of General Studies, cum laude.
Vivian A. Garcia.
Celeste Montserrat Garcia.
Daniel John Gibson.
Stephanie M. Garcia.
Israel Gibson, Associate of General Studies, magna cum laude.
Corey S. Garrison.
Anthony Gianvenco, Associates of General Studies, magna cum laude.
Isaiah J. Gibson.
Cameron E. Gonzalez, Indiana College Corps.
Owen L. Gnidic.
Sabrina M. Gonzalez, Indiana College Corps.
Isabella N. Gonzalez, magna cum laude.
Margaret I. Juan, Associate of General Studies, cum laude.
Fiona E. Guzman. Next row, please rise and approach the stage.
Grace E. Hansen, Associate of General Studies.
Diana B. Hallman.
Alicia R. Harrison.
Ethan M. Harmon.
Emma Hebert.
Aiden Hopman, Indiana College Corps.
Evan D. Hicks, Associate of General Studies.
Colin Hott.
Gage D. Horbovitz.
Aiden Christopher Howitt.
Jeffrey Ryan Howard, Associate of General Studies, magna cum laude.
Alexis A. Hunter.
Sierra E. Huitron.
Alyssa J. Janik, magna cum laude.
Brandon C. Eisen, Associate of General Studies, magna cum laude.
Destiny Alexis Jernigan.
Jacob C. Jenkins, Indiana College Corps.
Kaylee A. Johnson.
Jaden Gilson, Indiana College Corps.
Langston E. Jones.
Cody T. Johnson, cum laude.
Abigail A. Joswiak.
Madison N. Jones, Indiana College Corps.
Elizabeth L. Kaiser, cum laude.
Hunter A. Juris.
Sarah Kessler.
Grant J. Kappas, cum laude.
Carliana T. King. Next row, please rise and approach the stage.
Joshua Keitzman, Associate of General Studies.
Eve Clawater, Associate of Science and Liberal Arts, cum laude.
Olivia R. Kirkliski.
Anna M. Kneisler, Associate of General Studies, magna cum laude.
Addison R. Clem, Indiana College Corps, magna cum laude.
Jayla J. Lackney, Associate of General Studies, magna cum laude.
Heather M. Conja.
Nicolina Latinovich, Indiana College Corps, cum laude.
Logan William Tyler Lambert.
Marabella D. Lair.
Kara Lawrence.
Cheyenne Grace Lockhart.
Dominic M. Locke.
Macy Love Lucien, magna cum laude.
Madison N. Loeffler, Indiana College Corps.
Jeanette Magdaleno.
Nova Magdalena Mack, Associate of General Studies, cum laude.
Charisma M. Morales, Associate of General Studies, cum laude.
Stephen A. McSimmick.
Yeah. Ella D. Martinez.
Amara Rin Martinez.
Sophia S. Martin, Associate of Science in Liberal Arts, magna cum laude.
Maya Martinez.
Jonathan Modica.
Terry A. Martin.
Evan A. McBride.
Emma L. McCoy, Associate of General Studies, cum laude.
Jonathan S. McGill. Next row, please rise and approach the stage.
Andrew J. McKnight, Associate of General Studies.
Kerrigan T. Manier.
Melanie G. Messmer, Associate of General Studies, magna cum laude.
Clarissa Miller.
Gavin K. Miller Lane.
Noah Miller.
Nicasio M. Morales.
Frankie Mondragon.
Eulalia Marie Mojica.
Gianna Patrice Morales, magna cum laude.
Lindsay E. Montalva, Associate of General Studies, magna cum laude.
Jaquan Dwayne Morris.
Daisy J. Morgan.
Drop the stool.
Rachel L. Moyers.
Paige Elizabeth Morton.
Go Paige!
Keith Mullins.
Jenilyn Mullins, Associate of General Studies, magna cum laude.
Emily R. Neuenfeld, Associate of General Studies, summa cum laude.
Nathan D. Music.
Ryan N. Olivo.
Brooklyn A. Nixich, Associate of Science in Liberal Arts, magna cum laude.
Bea Rose Ortega.
Lillian E. Ondo.
Deja K. Parker.
Julianne Padlow, Indiana College Corps.
Logan Patrick Peak.
Nicholas P. Passy.
Logan T. Pershaw. Next row, please rise and approach the stage.
Mia M. Perez.
Faith Lene Diane Pimentel.
Abigail Pickett.
Ethan Pinniger, Associate of General Studies.
Ryan J. Pimentel.
Sky Blue Pinniger, cum laude.
Rochelle E. Puente, Indiana College Corps.
Matthew A. Popenhagen.
Nicholas R. Pockron.
Angelina M. Priestley, Associate of General Studies, summa cum laude.
Nathan Daniel Queer.
Joseph L. Kindonis.
Tyler W. Rashaw.
Nevaeh M. Randall.
Emma A. Ramos.
Nathaniel Vernon Resendez Velasquez, Indiana College Corps.
Eva Reyes, Indiana College Corps.
Austin Douglas Riley.
Alejandra A. Rios, Indiana College Corps.
Denise Rivera, Associate of General Studies, magna cum laude.
Carlos J. Rios.
Brendan Roberts.
Sophia Amor Robledo.
Gianna G. Rodriguez, Associate of General Studies, magna cum laude.
Ian Gabriel Andres Rodriguez, Associate of General Studies, summa cum laude.
Giovanni Rodriguez Munoz,
Rita Manuela Rodriguez.
Sarah I. Romeo, Associate of General Studies, cum laude. Next row, please rise and approach the stage.
Aiden C. Rosinski.
Christopher Sachs.
Jenna Shehalis Sage.
Jalen C. Saldana.
Ava R. Samus.
David U. Sanchez.
Isabella A. Sanchez.
Owen Sasak.
Lucas Ryan Saunders.
Alana R. Scott.
Michaela Scott, Associates of General Studies, magna cum laude.
Kyle Edward Scroggins.
Woo, Kyle! Woo!
James Sheets.
Michaela Saros.
Taryn Lee Sinclair.
Madeline E. Simpson, Indiana College Corps.
Brooklyn T. Smith.
Haley M. Skripak.
Easton T. Smith.
Colin S. Smith.
Emma L. Spinks, Indiana College Corps.
Jaden F. Somerville.
Chloe Ann Stevens.
Heather A. Stevens, Associate of General Studies, cum laude.
Madeline Joanne Stone.
Hannah Leanne Marie Stewart.
Hannah Stroud.
Vonzel Anthony Strayhorn. Next row, please rise, approach the stage.
Shane F. Tessman.
Sean M. Sullivan.
Aiden J. Thompson.
Ethan M. Theodorakis.
Kyle A. Tolliver.
Michael E. Tibbs.
Jose A. Torres, Indiana College Corps.
Gabrielle I. Tomich, Associate of General Studies, magna cum laude.
Alyssa Inez Toscani, Associate of General Studies, summa cum laude.
Maria I. Torres.
Alan Turich.
Trevor C. Triana.
Stephanie Unsueto.
Lene Umstead.
Juan Mateo Vargas.
Eddie Valdez.
Alexander F. Vasquez.
Mia Bella Vargas.
Christian M. Velasquez.
Cecilia Ann Vega Johnson, Indiana College Corps.
Diego J. Verduzco, Indiana College Corps, cum laude.
Augustine A. Verduzco.
Associate of General Studies, summa cum laude.
Thomas Michael Wachowski.
Kylie E. Watts, Associate of Science in Liberal Arts, magna cum laude.
Ryan R. Wine, Associate of General Studies, cum laude.
Alexandra Justine Wendell.
Connor J. Wenzel. Next row, please rise and approach the stage.
Danielle Whitaker.
Tessa White.
Devin R. Weibel.
Alexander P. Wick.
Thomas R. Williamson.
Isaiah Wilson, Associate of General Studies.
Okay, Savannah N. Woodruff.
Liam Wright.
Amber Rose Yeager.
Julia C. Zimney, Indiana College Corps, cum laude.
TJ Quinones.
Jaden Harrison.
Jacqueline Ruby Ramirez, Indiana College Corps.
Gabe Von Dickerson, Indiana College Corps.
Bryce Anthony Bartok.
Kaden M. Sobchak.
As your senior sponsors, let us begin with congratulations on your achievements and best wishes on the next chapter of your life.
Every year, we always give a short speech at your graduation with a few pearls of wisdom to take with you. Here you go.
About life. Know that life is 10% of what happens to you and 90% what you do with what happens to you.
About relationships. Know that they don't last because of the good times. They last because the hard times were handled with love and care.
About joy. Joy does not simply happen to you. You must choose joy and keep choosing it every day.
About wishes and decisions. Remember, one good wish changes nothing, but one good decision changes everything.
About appreciation. Know that sometimes you will just need to pause and appreciate all that is good in your life.
About kindness. A quote from William Wordsworth, "The best portion of a good person's life are the little, nameless, unremembered acts of kindness and love."
About feeling overwhelmed as an adult, remember to take one thought at a time, one task at a time, and one day at a time. Remember to breathe.
About control. There are going to be things you cannot control, of course. Just focus on what you can control and let go of what you cannot.
What can you control? Your manners, your attitude, your efforts, your words, and finally, your attitude.
We will leave you with enjoy life and know this is not goodbye forever. This is not the end. This is to your future. And until we meet again, always your 2023 senior sponsors.
And now with the singing of the alma mater, once again, please welcome Wolfgang.
On the count of three, you know what to do. Oh my God.
Before I do that, remember to return your caps and gowns into the end zone where you can pick up your diploma this evening. One, two, three.